All right, everybody, welcome to the show. Seems like I'm struggling. Time. It's all John's fault. John's not on there. I don't know what time I'm supposed to go on. Somebody texts me, "Are you going on tonight?" I'm like, "I don't know. I'm just sitting here watching Dave Chappelle." And I look at my phone and I'm like, "Well, shit, it's after 7 o'clock. I got another message too. I'm live. Okay, cool. It's on another model. All right, so cheers to John for not showing up tonight.
I gotta make one. I don't think I have much left.
I'm gonna try not to be too drunk tonight like I was last week. What up, Tracy?
I guess I'll make a cocktail.
Man, Tracy, after you left, dude, that woman was weird, weird, weird. Holy crap. So that last yard sale we saw you at, Tracy, that one out there in that neighborhood that had like two houses. So I asked her. So she had, at the end of the driveway, she had a pet bed and some pet steps. And I, pet steps sell good at the auction. And so I said, "Man, there's only 20 people in here. Y'all need to hear this story." I said, "You got to wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. All right. Once 50 people get here, I'll tell the story." Christine Wilson, hey, I don't recognize your name, but welcome to the madness. What is said in an alcoholic stupor do not hold against
me. Right.
Tonight, we're still finishing off this bottle.
And this bottle.
This show should be, the Friday night show should be presented by, I like Canadians because they make good caramel whiskey.
Can we get sponsored? That would be outstanding.
All right. Anybody else want to come and say hello? And don't say you don't have cameras because Craig, you little bitch, I know you go live. I've been on your damn shows. So anybody who wants to, it's been an interesting. So I'll actually talk reselling until the yard sale one in a few minutes. Mr. Dark Horse, what's happening? You got to be tough to be a reseller. I'm here to tell you right now. Yesterday was a terrible day sourcing. Okay, it's not terrible. I made money. It's okay. I was in store number 11 before I bought anything. 11. Wow. I'm like thinking, how many stops before somebody quits and decides they're putting in applications? Oh, Christine's been lurking. Well, I appreciate you watching that, Christine. I hope you must be tough because I haven't offended you yet, or I've offended you, and you've decided to hell with me. You'll listen anyway. Man, on stop number 11, though, I walk in there, and one of the items that I try to find is hard to find, discontinued. I've never seen so much of it. I usually buy, the most I've ever seen of this item is 3. They had 23. Sent a picture to Jennifer. I sent it to Dave. I think I might have been, was I on the phone with you, Dave, or I just got on the phone with you after I found it?
Yeah.
I'm like, dude, you ain't gonna believe this. Holy crap. So I walk into a store and find $700 worth of shit. I mean, it changes that fast. So I'm gonna tell you, the plan wasn't bad. The stops weren't bad. I think I might have been in an area where somebody does what I do. And sometimes that happens with retail arbitrage. And you got to keep going. And so there was one point in the day yesterday, I had stopped at 24 stores. And I had only bought stuff in 4 stores. 4. So I altered the plan. So there's lots of lessons here. You know, the way I was going, I decided it was not great. And I needed to change my luck. So first thing I did was I got rid of the country music. I was listening to damn real country music riding through Tennessee. I got rid of the country music. I started listening to, I think, 3 Days Grace. If y'all know, I've seen 3 Days Grace in concert about four or five times. They're amazing. And is it any wonder that my luck turned around on the song Chalk Outline, one of my favorite 3 Days Grace songs? It's probably not an accident. It's not a coincidence. So I cut the top part of the route off, decided I was going to go back down towards where I was the other day And I finished the last 13 stores by buying 12 out of 13, something in 12 out of 13. So, Biff Boffo, I can't tell you how many times that happens. You know, so especially, so retail arbitrage might be a touch different. So, and Dave will tell you this is 100% true. If there's a store that's kind of out of the way somewhere, or I'm tired and I'm trying to decide whether I need to go to that store or not, or do I have enough time? Is it worth the effort? 9 out of 10 times, that is a killer store.
Sorry.
You get over there and go, oh my God, I am so glad I talked myself into that. What was I thinking? It happened so, I can't tell you. It happens so many times. So I finished the day out pretty strong. I found probably a third of what I've been finding. Not great, but when you're doing discontinued, it only takes a few items to start making money. And so positive motivator is mileage deduction. I generally have a big mileage deduction. Yesterday alone, I put gas in the car twice yesterday, right at the start and then right before I got home. And I could have made it home without gas, but Harlan Tyree showed up at my house at freaking like 6:05. Ain't nobody got time to go get gas at 6:05. Tomorrow morning, Harlan Tyree shows up at 5:30. Ain't nobody got time for 5:30 gas. And nobody got time to go to the bank. So I've already been to the bank for cash for tomorrow. He swears he's going to wear the camera tomorrow. So I'm going to wear the camera tomorrow. We got 44. Is that close enough to 50?
Close enough.
Okay. So I'm at a yard sale. Tracy's already there. This is the yards. Okay. So you want to see how evil Tracy is? T flips. If everybody doesn't know, right there in the bottom, T flips. T flips is evil. I walk up to this yard sale. He's already there. And I tell the lady, I'm like, man, you've only been out of jail a couple hours. This is the first thing you're going to do is go to a yard sale? Tracy's laughing. The lady goes, oh, you must know them. Me and Harlan walking up the driveway. And I'm looking around. And I grab a – she had a stoneware what's the name of the dang company? It was 50 cent for a big stoneware – not Pioneer Woman, but whoever they are. And there was a cookie, a cat cookie jar or something for $1. And then I start looking by Tracy because there's a couple things in front of him. And he looks down in a bucket and goes, oh, wait a minute, what's that? He'd already been through this bucket. Harlan had been through this bucket. There is a freaking Nintendo 2DS with the damn charger attached to it. And neither one of them has seen it the first time. And Tracy picks it up and goes, ma'am, how much you want for this little game thing? God is my witness, I'm not lying. She looks at it, she goes, that's my grandkids. How about 50 cents? You planned that, Tracy. I will go to my grave. You knew that thing was in there, and you were just taunting me by reaching down there in front of me, knowing that I was about to go in that bucket and to pick up the 50 cents 2DS, and it worked. Tracy, did it have a game in it? It probably had a game in it. 50 cents. He got a 2DS out of your... You hear about this stuff happening and go, people are lying. That never happens. A 50 cent 2DS. Okay, so I'm really not that way. As long as me, Harlan, or Tracy pick it up, I am good. I'd rather somebody I know pick it up and really... So I'm glad Tracy got that because the stuff I got is going through the auction, it'll be fine. He claims he didn't do it, but okay. So here we go. So we go right around the corner, and there's a lady having a yard sale. This is supposedly a neighborhood yard sale. Friday, Saturday, only two houses. Okay, so there's a pet bed laying at the end of the driveway, and a set of pet steps. At the auction, pet steps do wonderful. You know, they'll go $15-$20. And so I said, "Ma'am, how much for the pet steps?" And I don't think she heard that I said they were pet steps. And she says, do you know what those are? And I'm sitting here thinking, it says Rover on the side of it and it steps. Of course I know what the fuck they are. And she says, they're pit stiffs. And I'm like, yeah, why? What did you think they were? And Harlan looks at me and she goes, she starts talking about, well, some people could use it to get in the right position for, you know. Oh my God. I wish I had the camera. I missed the part where Harlan said, Harlan gets back in the van and goes, that woman was weird. I'm like, what do you mean weird? He goes, she kept saying, yeah, that's my husband there, but that's my baby. There were two guys. And then I'm like, you heard what she said about the pet steps, and now she's got her husband and her baby over there. And she kept, everything it was some comment that everything there was a sexual reference to whatever. I'm like, there's some. But they couldn't leave the yard sale, no matter what. I don't get offended. I wasn't offended, but because everything was so damn cheap. I've never seen one before. It's a glass it's got a dispenser. It's made by a Berkey dispenser. I didn't realize Berkey made just like regular clear glass and dispensers. I asked the guy, I'm like, did I buy the steps? Yeah, they were $3. I bought the damn steps. I bought the pet bed too for $2. I said, how much for the dispenser? He looks at it and goes, oh, heck, I don't know. How about $1? And it's one of those big ones. It's like 2.5 gallons. It says Berkey on it. I guess it's going to be worth something. I gotta look.
It'll be worth a bunch. Just the dispenser without the filtration system, it'll still be worth
one. No, it's just a glass like filled up like lemonade or something. It's not
okay.
I asked him how much was this pair of boots? I'd never heard of these boots before. And he says, I guess I'm gonna have to tell you the same thing I just told you, $1. And there was like three other things I asked this dude how much it was. And he's like, I keep telling you it's $1. I want it gone.
Okay, Jennifer, we did not need to think about that one.
So there was a thing. A little...
Did I derail your conversation, Scott?
Jennifer did. She made me take a drink there. I brought out this box. It was this thing. It was this kit that said how to make your own hot sauce. And I'm like, what's this? I'm like, she looks at it and she goes, she calls her husband's name. She goes, I just gave you that for last Father's Day. You hadn't even used it yet. And that proceeded for the next 5 or 6 items we found. Was something that she had given him that he never used that he threw out in the fucking yard sale. And she sold it for $1. I'm sitting there trying to wrap my brain around this going, you're mad at him for selling shit at the yard sale that he's not gone through, and you're selling it for $1. And then I'm looking at this bag that's got all this trinkets and stuff in it. And she goes, oh, I won that as a door prize. I hadn't even looked through any of that stuff either. And I'm like, you're saying something to him about not using something, and you're throwing your door prizes out in the garage sale. It's $25 there. I think Harlan spent like $32. Yeah, man, we bought a ton. But yeah, that was weird. So drink every time you say dollar. Man, this guy was in. He was in a hydroponics, the boyfriend, I guess, her baby was in a hydroponics. So Harlan was buying, because Harlan has, at the house he rents, has these raised flower beds, and so he grows peppers and stuff. And so he was buying, this dude had like all these hydroponics, all the fertilizers and stuff. Harlan's like, what you want for that? He goes, dollar. I've never seen this before, but there's some kind of thing that you put over seeds, some kind of heated something for seeds with a remote control.
Heat pad, yeah.
Heat pad for seeds.
I'm like, yeah.
How much do you want for this? He said that number that I'm not going to drink again for. It was still new in the box.
Oh, wow.
That was the craziest yard sale. Yeah.
Is it safe to say that Harlan bought 32 items then?
Oh my God. So then bless this dude's heart. I don't want y'all to think bad about me and how I'm about to describe this fella. We got through this yard sale, the last one of the day before we went to estate sales. And he had a dog. It's a Yorkshire Terrier, 18 months old, he said. It was running around hyper and barking. What do you expect a Yorkie to do this less than 2 years old? You expect it to bark and run around. Okay, so, you know, we were looking at shoes and stuff because he said he sold shoes. And he had a couple nice pairs of shoes. And they were all $3. And the dog would come over and we speak to it. And then it'd run between me and Harlan. And it'd run around. It'd bark at us. And he told us some story about how he bought the dog for $700 and he sold it to somebody. And they thought it was too hyper. They thought something was wrong with it. So he bought it back for the same amount of money. And then he looks at us with a straight face and says, I think that dog has autism. That's all I could do not to laugh. I had to turn away and look. I'm like, because this dude was not he's not the sharpest crayon in the pack. And we get back in the van and Harlan looks at me. And Harlan never says anything about anybody. It's me who was always carrying on. He's like, a dog with autism. That motherfucker had autism. If anybody had autism.
I can't imagine Harlan saying anything negative about anyone.
never does, but when he was, I guess he had a little short fuse with Harlan because of the, you know, insulting the animal when he said, the dude's just crazy. But man, this is, I'm telling you right now, go to yard sales with your friends. They're so much more fun. They're absolutely more fun. There's plenty of stuff to go around. You can buy lots of stuff.
You just need a smaller camera or something that's just super easy to.
Today was the day to wear the camera because that would have. There's no telling what that woman at that 1 yard sale would have said with the camera on.
Mm-hmm. With a little help.
So that was our morning. Then we went to estate sales. We picked up a few things, odds and ends, at estate sales, but estate sales are a little more expensive, and we will pick up things there to run to the auction. We picked up some Corningware. We both bought Corningware today. But that was I need the glasses with the camera build. I do need the Ray-Bans if they were so expensive. But I wonder how long they'll record. John was looking into them. I need to figure that out.
Is there just one model of them so far?
I think so, yeah.
Ray-Ban.
Smart Ray-Bans. Hey, Chassie, good evening.
You said they're not Ray-Ban?
I thought they were Ray-Bans. Are they not
Ray-Bans? That's what I'm asking, yeah.
The Ray-Ban. Because I see her on TikTok all the time talking about challenging people to take a picture faster than she does, and she's got the glasses or whatever on. Yeah, but that was the yard sales are so much fun. You never know what you're gonna run into. You never know who the people. It's
300 versions by Ray-Ban.
Three versions.
Mm-hmm.
Is it that time? Is it time for bong hit championships?
Sure. Hit the bong. Yeah, it's absolute the fun of the people you meet. That's the most fun about yard sales. It's even when I'm doing retail arbitrage, I meet a lot of nice people. You know, even though I was struggling yesterday mightily, they were lots and lots of nice folks. And man, food has got.
60 seconds is the max. The default is 30 seconds. It can be 15, 30, or 60.
Yeah, that's not long enough.
And that's built into the Meta system, the Meta ecosystem. Facebook, whatever.
The Meta.
Now, I'm going to guess there's probably going to be a better version, I'm sure, you know, as they figure out how to store stuff more or better or whatever, more storage and more battery. Because I'm sure the battery is the issue.
But I'm going to tell you, anything worth doing is not It's not easy. So, and Jennifer's hanging out in the chat. She's been watching a lot of Whatnot and wants to start doing Whatnot probably after Nashville. So, man, come to Nashville. Nashville Flippers think they're having that meetup, but you're taking over. So join us in Nashville, April 26th to 28th. The hotel's in Goodlettsville, Tennessee, at the Holiday Express. I guarantee you, you'll learn plenty. There's no classes, there's no teaching, there's none of that stuff, and I guarantee you'll learn an absolute ton. You'll meet great people. I watched Ray's. I caught the tail in his Whatnot last night. Ray's good people. He and Dustin are good dudes. And I guarantee you, you'll have a lot of fun in Nashville. If you're anywhere in the Nashville area, come join us.
We'll be there.
There's a Facebook group. It's only $50 to join, and my PayPal, I'll give it to you.
Now, well, we could buy one of those Ray-Ban glasses pretty quickly if we started to just, $55 birthday gift.
Nashville to Ray-Ban. That's what we're doing. Nashville to Ray-Ban.
I'm starting to get
FOMO. I'm pretty sure somebody just turned 55. So, I mean, isn't it $1 per year? Isn't that the standard gift?
Who the hell turned 55? What the hell?
I know. Old fart.
Dave?
Yeah, just keep pointing.
I'm still in my 40s.
All right. So, if y'all are not aware, I had a birthday this week. I did turn 55. I don't look 55 though. I don't even act 40, much less 55.
And well, we're gonna go with the act part, especially.
Jennifer says we're bringing the whole crew. You'll meet Harlan's new lady. I've been messing with her on Facebook. She's exceptionally funny. Harlan, I don't know what he's done in life to deserve a second shot at this, but he's definitely overachieved. Jacob will be there. I'll be there. Even Tracy will be there. T Flips, who never comes on camera.
All right, here we go.
So what Harlan or be able to live stream that weekend? I'll have my computer and stuff. Maybe we'll try to live stream from somewhere in the hotel.
It's gonna be Friday night. We'll have to do something.
I don't think he has a. I wouldn't call it a leash. She's cool. Oh, and some cool chick named Dawn, and that other one, Mary Lady. Cool Dawn is gonna be there and drag Mary with her. Because Mary's old. Oh, wait a minute. Mary's a young one. Two hip chicks will be there. So if you follow those ladies, they have a wonderful channel. Unfortunately, I was so driving and so busy, I could not play Estatesville Bingo. I wish I was playing Estatesville Bingo yesterday because I'm sure I would have won. Larry sometimes in the chat. Larry's going to be there. Patrick Murphy's doing a flyby. Hey, Patrick, how are you? Man, Dave. Here comes. So, Tom Higgins, what is the state sell bingo? So on Thursday, it's 11 a.m. Central, so I guess that's 12 Eastern. Dawn and Mary will pick an estate sale in their area. And so there's some website that will allow you to make a bingo card. So Mary is the ruler of all and the judge, and her laws are pretty strict. Has come up with all these things that you find at an estate sale. And so you tell it to give you a bingo card, and then you fill in the bingo card as we look at the pictures to the estate. So it's brilliant. It's a lot of fun. And there'll be stuff on there like a collection of silverware or pitchers or glass tables. There, I mean, all the stuff that you find at estate sales is there. They add more and more to it. Mary's rule is law. It does seem that way because, Dawn, we tried to overrule her, and she's pretty stern. Like a Billy Bass is on there. That's right, Patrick. It's just an interesting way to look at an estate sale. Because sometimes they go to them and sometimes they don't. But
that's right.
All right, Jacob, you don't have to do that.
555. Just rubbing it in.
Do y'all want me to break this down? For those of you who are challenged in math and believe what people tell you, let's see here. Middle age is 38. Jacob, you're already middle age and you don't want to admit it.
Wow. That's why I'm putting you up at the middle age.
the average age of the American male is like 78 and the woman is 79. So if you're over 38 or 39, you have hit mid age.
Middle age.
Join me, shall you?
Well, my grandmother was 96, so I'm not middle age yet. My great grandmother, sorry.
Yeah, my grandparents were 86, 87, 89, and 91.
My wife's grandma lived to be 103. Pretty impressive.
Now she was the only one that lived to be over 90, though, of the ones that I know of, or the ones that I met, I guess, that were alive in my lifetime.
I'm about to trade Joni, and Joni didn't give me anything for my birthday.
What? No way.
Well, if we only get 100 more people, no, 50 more people to do the same thing, you can buy your glasses.
So wait, you didn't get to use the stairs?
And what?
The stairs.
What stairs?
The steps.
did not get to use the pet steps for my birthday.
I mean, I would have been like, well, I don't know. I got to give this a whirl. They're onto something.
You got to make sure it works before you sell it.
Tested and working great.
There you go. You asked me what I wanted for my birthday. How about we try out the pet steps for my birthday? There you go. All right, is that what y'all wanted? See that? Okay, so here's a little secret. I'm gonna let out this huge secret. Joni acts so prim and proper and carrying on. Joni, my wife is insane. If you've never met Joni in person, ask Jennifer.
She's batshit crazy.
There's a reason why we were down in Orlando and Tracy looked at Joni and goes, "You crazy as hell." And for the rest of like 3 or 4 days, every time we see her, "You're crazy as hell.
Crazy as hell."
I'm telling you.
Was that the only time Tracy's ever seen your wife?
I don't know. He had to go all the way to Orlando to meet her.
I was going to say,
I didn't think about that.
She was pretty crazy in Vegas, so there was that.
Yeah, Jennifer got a full week of Joni at the beach. Oh, my God.
A full week. I think what's my top? So 4 days, 5 days?
Nuts. But yes, I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Tomorrow's one of the bigger neighborhood sales of the year already in Huntsville, and we've only had the yard sales for a couple. Jennifer, we did have a good time. I really enjoyed that week at the beach. Tracy will be over there. I'm sure me and Harlan will be quite a few. But there's like 8 neighborhoods that all kind of tie together, running together. They call it one huge community. They're all having yard sales tomorrow. And then the week after that, the other side of the main highway, Taylor Road has theirs. And so for two weekends in a row, we'll be over there. Just quite a few yard sales. So looking forward to that tomorrow. Need to somebody remind me after before the show ends and before I tell y'all hey, one more thing. And then remind me to charge the batteries for that camera. So Tracy says USC just beat NC State. What are you talking about? Is that women's Final Four? I don't know what that is. So I was told today by a lady asked at one of these states, she asked me, was I watching the game tomorrow? And I'm like, well, I have not watched any of them, and we've won the last four, and we're in the finals for the first time ever. I'm probably not going to watch tomorrow because. William, I would prefer not to the communities, but this one is so good. The first hour of this one is so strong. It is an affluent area too. So I'm looking forward to that tomorrow. But yeah, and I'm not going to watch Alabama's game tomorrow because I don't want to jinx us by watching us lose. I want us to at least have a chance by. If we made it to the Final Four for the first time ever. And your reward is you get to play UConn, who's had a lead of at least 30 on every opponent in the tournament so far. Tom said he found a Purdue basketball shirt yesterday. That's one of the teams we've already played, Tom, and we've already lost to Purdue once this year. I think we lost by 6 to Purdue early on, first month of the season. Hey, Ron, what's up, buddy? Hey, Ron, is Texas A&M in the Final Four? Y'all had Houston. You should have beat Houston. What the hell?
What the hell, man? What are you doing?
Anybody got any reselling questions, or you just want us to drunk ramble for a while?
Just mess around, man.
I can tell you, the streamlining is working, folks. Get the right size boxes for what you ship. Get the right equipment. I'm telling you, I ship so fast now with the tape machine. Man, the 10-4-4 boxes are amazing. For all the stuff that I've been selling, they fit right. And I've got 12-4 in case I've got a little longer. I have 12-4-4. It makes such a huge difference if you streamline what you're doing. So I do have a couple big items. So there was the lady. the pet step lady. Everybody remember the pet step lady? She had something in her driveway. Me and Tracy tried to figure out what the hell it was. It was some kind of water dispenser, a water distiller. It was some kind of water distiller. It had its own pitcher. And I asked her, I'm like, what does this do? And she's like, it's, I don't know. I'm like, and I just looked it up and I'm like, ooh, what do you want for it? And she's like, I don't know. What about $5? I'm like, I can do $5. That's a $225 water distiller. Don't sleep on a water distiller. It's Trace and I were looking at it, and we walked away. And I looked at it again. I picked up the picture, and the picture said "Made in Germany." I'm like, "Made in Germany." Yeah. I gotta look this up. That is a clue.
Yeah.
Anything made in Germany is generally expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So that made up for the video game, Tracy, that you swiped out.
What brand was it?
You taunted in front of me. I'm looking it up right now. I can't remember what brand.
By the way, those classes do hands-free live streaming to Facebook or Instagram, just FYI, even though it'll only do 60 seconds of recorded video. So you could go live streaming on your Facebook channel so everybody can just see it all in real time.
It was that right there. It's a mega home.
Okay.
See the big picture that comes with it?
Uh-huh.
See the price of it used? Oh, sorry.
Nope. All right.
They want $175 free shipping. I think I can get $175 plus shipping to push it around $200.
Uh-huh. Hey, if you test it out, make sure it works. Call me before you sell it.
All right. I don't even know how to make it work.
I'm sure
the whole top pops up. I think it must fill the water in there, and then
probably. Call me before you sell, before you list it.
Jeanette asked a great question. Do I polybag lotions? Generally, I do not.
You should. Anything you're shipping liquid should be polybagged.
Required to have two seals by post office.
That's what will protect you for insurance as well. Depends on how much the lotion is. Could be a $90 bottle of lotion.
I have a shrink wrap machine. I generally shrink wrap.
There you go. That's a good one too. That's an even better one.
She said specifically poly bag. I shrink wrap generally.
Mm-hmm.
There's a difference. So I generally put a piece of tape over the whatever the top is, and I shrink wrap that, and then I put it in the box.
Yeah.
Yeah. See how Dave was assuming I didn't do anything. You see that?
I didn't assume. I'm just playing along.
But that's actually a great. I mean, that's a very good question, because if somebody does want their insurance to cover it, it does have to have two seals.
I feel I don't know what you're trying to say. Where did I get that idea from? I've had that thing since 2016. That shrink wrap thing. I've got two of them.
Ideally, that's the best way.
I'm telling you right now, I've got two of them. I picked up one at a yard sale, for God's sakes. You can find stuff at yard sales. I was on one of these long, I think, was it the 127? Or it might have been the, what's the one that goes from Gadsden to Knoxville? Is that the 44 or the 40, whatever that one is? I think it might have been on that one. The guy had an 18-inch, U-ship or U-line shrink wrap holder with four containers of shrink wrap box of the packages and then one 18-inch roll. I'm like, he's like, do you even know what that is? I'm like, I think I got an idea. What you want for it? He goes, oh, man, give me $20 for it. $20. The 411. That's it, Tracy. The 411.
Just to be clear, too, on something that needs to be polybagged or shrink-wrapped, it doesn't necessarily have to be entirely shrink-wrapped. That's why they make, like, just like on a bottle of liquor, plastic seal. If you can create a plastic barrier over just the top of the bottle, you're good. That's actually the ideal way to get...
But the way that shrink-wrap is too soft that it doesn't... It won't, the hard
shit, you know?
The bags that I've got are harder... And they're much faster, so they would actually work with one of the regular seal things, because you just got to close it in one end. Glenn said he found a ZP450 with labels for $10. Man, that is incredible, folks. I'm absolutely telling you, you can up your game at yard sales if you don't do anything else. We got a yard. Last year, I found two Dymo printers. I found a Bluetooth scanner. There's no telling how many laser printers I found at the yard that I found last year at the yard sale. This year I'm going to run them all through the auction. I'm still going to buy them. How many Brother printers did I buy last year for $5 that had toner in them?
That hadn't been used much.
Toner doesn't go bad, folks. It just doesn't. It's not like ink. It doesn't go bad. One of my computers out there is using a monitor that I picked up because the screen is bad. I pick up Apple keyboards. I like the Apple keyboard, so I've got several Apple keyboards outside. It is amazing. Tracy got a Dymo 450 for $3 last week. That's the 450 Turbo. That's some folks. It's out there. You want to up your game, and you want label printers, and you want all these things. I'm telling you. Find some yard sales. Even our auction, you know, they had a Dymo printer a couple weeks ago. William Sutter said it, the Wink instant spot stain. Never even heard of that. Said it, can't find any more at your local hardware stores. Well, I'm going to go look at mine then, William. And then while I'm out and about, I'm going to look at everybody else's around me too. Let's see what it looks like.
Yeah.
eBay? Does anybody know what Wink looks like?
I know of the brand.
The blue bottle?
I don't know.
And then there's a rust stain remover. It looks like it does pretty well too.
So it hangs on a cardboard thing, and it looks all right. Thanks, William. Appreciate it. It's amazing. There's just so much stuff out there. Right. Anything Apple. So Tom, you're 100% correct. Those keyboards, they're easy to test. Most people have. Okay, so half the people out there have iPhones. There's one person on the panel who's bound and determined not to use one. So me and Dave will talk about them. I hit the wrong one. You're going to have to come back, Jacob.
Poor Jacob.
They kicked him all the way out of the studio. Oops.
Yeah. You got to start over.
Boredom says, I never see any printers at yard sales in Vegas. I guess you just don't open your eyes.
Well, should you tell them the other way?
So I meant to just kick him out of the studio. I didn't mean to kick him all the way out. Dang, now I feel bad.
You can always check the marketplace
for printers. Why did, which one did I... How do you do the one where it just makes it go?
Put you in backstage instead. Oh,
oh my God. I should have done that.
Time out.
That's the one I meant to do.
You hit the all the way eject, right?
Hey, you see what happened when you turn 55? You just lose your abilities to remember how to do things just goes away.
Ah.
Ron, I would put them. That's a great question, Ron. Ron asked, found 18 jars of mincemeat, good through Christmas. That sell it or hold it? I would put it at a price that I'd be happy with, Ron. And if it sold, I'd sell it. If not, I just. And so that's the way I would handle it. That's the way I handle a lot of things. Go ahead and get it listed, put the price up there you'd be happy with. And if people buy it, take your money and move on. Even if it might be a touch lower, just think about how many times you can flip
money.
Turn that money, because the whole name of the game in reselling is how many times can you turn the cash? Yeah. It's cash flow. It's churn of your inventory. And
just widgets, you know? You just keep
need to. And the other thing specifically about mincemeat might be that, remember, it only gets put on the retail shelves once a year.
Right.
And people might still like that nasty stuff.
But
if it's in date and you can suffer hold it, it'd probably be worth holding.
I mean, I think right now we'd probably do really well because it'll all be sold out everywhere.
So I'm going to I wrote down the inventory churn. That's a good topic. I'll get John. One of the things we talk about, not tomorrow. There is a Profit Playbook podcast out tomorrow, 8 a.m. Central. I think Central, 8 a.m. Central. 8 a.m. sometime. Maybe it's 8 a.m. Pacific. I don't know when it comes out. It comes out tomorrow morning. We have a special guest. We have a special guest, A. That's all I'm going to say.
What's up, folks?
Are you at home? Have you been banned and been sent home? What the hell?
She sent me home. Marcia sent me home, y'all.
And just think about this.
What'd you do?
Last week, Harlan was dragging his ass. And last night, what did she tell you?
She told me I had to go home early and rest so I could be ready for the yard sales.
So you could be ready for the lady with the dog slash.
There's some real love going on there.
I'm telling y'all don't understand. This dude has hit a grand slam. The more I hear about her, the more I'm impressed with her. And she laughs and jokes with me on Messenger, so that's even better.
She is.
Yeah.
And she's watching right now. So love you, baby. she was watching. I mean, she was watching the show, and I'm in there working on Van Massey lots, and she's texting me about the show. I missed all the stories about the pet steps today.
You didn't tell her about them?
I did.
I mean, how did you miss those? You lived that one live and in person. That woman, did I miss anything? What else did that lady say? She was so weird.
Oh, it was funny because Scott said, "How much are these?" And she goes, "Oh, that's probably not what you think they are. These are pet steps." And I'm like, "What? What was that? What were we thinking? I mean, I'm thinking pet steps, right?"
Where are we going here?
What? I don't know where else they could be. And I mean, it's like, it looks like steps that climb up onto something. I mean, what are we talking about? And then she said something like, "Honey," she goes, "No, that's my other honey." And I'm like, "Okay, I see what's going on right now." She goes, "That's my neighbor. That's my husband." And she goes, "I know these look like the cushion things where you can try different sex positions." And I'm like, not the first thing that came to my mind, but I got an idea what's going on in this neighborhood right here. I do. So yeah. So that was the way we started the day off. So
and then we found out that dogs have autism.
Oh yeah. Yeah, this guy's like, "I don't know about this dog. I think he has autism." And I'm like, I'm thinking that's probably not a thing. I'm not even going to say what I said after that. It probably wouldn't be.
I'm like, "That's all right."
Oh, my bad. I didn't say that. Scott said it.
I'm the one that said it.
Scott said it.
Yeah,
I said it.
Yeah. Upside down pineapples.
No, we didn't see
pineapples in the yard. No pampas grass either.
There was probably upside down pineapples everywhere. We just missed them.
No, I would have noticed that if that was in there. Was I noticed everything else was about a dollar. That was a dollar, dollar, dollar.
I had a joke though. Like, yeah, I don't know about the yard sale. We both picked up hoes today. What a great day at the yard sales.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome.
I got that's a garden. That's a garden hoe for everybody listening.
A hoe, yeah. It's whatever you want it to be. I don't care.
Right. Wow.
Yeah, that was. I mean, folks were giving stuff away. Harlan got the. He negotiated five tools for $5, and the lady goes, "Oh, there's some post hole diggers over here. We'll throw them in too for the same money." I'm like,
mm-hmm. Yeah, that was nice. She goes, "You need some post hole diggers?" And I'm like, "Well, somebody probably does. I don't, because I'm not digging the holes." What I'm thinking, somebody out there is probably going to need some post hole diggers.
Right.
And I said, "How much you want?" She goes, "Just throw them in for the $5 deal." And I'm like, I like how she thinks.
Yeah, those are the weird. I'm like, "These are some huge shoes." She goes, "Oh yeah, that's my husband's size. He's 6'5". These were size 14 shoes." He was he worked something with New Balance, and so there's New Balance stuff everywhere. I got a cool pair of shoes.
We got the ones you bought the what's the shoes? The Minnetonka. Yeah. This woman came in there, she was at the estate sale. She said, "This woman wears like a size 10 shoe and like a 4 dress. She had big feet." I said, "She ain't gonna sneak up on nobody, is she?" I said, "Man, we should have had the camera rolling for that one."
Oh, yeah. We both swore we're gonna wear cameras tomorrow, so y'all are not gonna miss them tomorrow.
I gotta find my charger for my batteries.
Well, if I'll bring it for the, I've got them in the van already, Harley. So if you need to charge them when we first start, they'll be in the van. So I'll be wearing I'll be wearing a camera tomorrow. So if you're gonna steal at the yard sales I'm at, don't do it in front of the camera.
Or if you got recently released from jail or anything like that.
Yeah, we ran into our buddy Alabama Chad, not to be confused with Tennessee Chad. And I come up there telling that the same thing. And Chad turns around and says, "You look good for them clearing up your venereal diseases." I'm like, "Oh God."
Oh no.
I'm telling you, it's yard selling with friends is a hoot. It is so much. We have a blast yard selling with friends. Y'all just don't know.
Shit, I got to like witness it live. It was freaking hilarious watching the two of you work together.
My favorite yard sales last year are when Kristen Ostrander was here last year. We had me and Kristen had so much fun. They followed us around through these huge neighborhoods. And that was a blast last year. I think Harlan froze, either that or he's gotten good at us.
Nah, you guys are a great team. Like you tag team the shit out of it and make it make sense. You know,
Harlan and I, we bought a lot of stuff today. We only went to like six or seven, four yard sales and three estate sales, and we filled up well over half the van.
I went to one with you. I watched you guys both each create a pile at the same yard sale, and the woman had maybe 20% of her shit left.
That swinger lady, if you would, we laugh about that a lot because
this is funny.
Swinger lady, anybody coming up behind us would have thought, what is she selling? She doesn't have anything. Why is she having? We bought so much. I had to back up in the driveway. We bought so much shit at that yard sale.
Can you hear me now?
No.
Okay, good. Now I've got an echo.
Oh.
It's only on your side.
Yeah.
I thought I kicked that other one out. Oh, I kicked the wrong one. Did I kick the wrong one out? Oops.
Gotta roll tonight.
Turning 55 sucks. Come back, Harlan.
What kind are you drinking today?
That's the okay. Kick that one from the studio. All right, he's not back.
He gone.
That was wrong. I'm terrible at this. This is my first live show, folks. If y'all didn't know, I'm the bearded picker. Act like I hadn't done this for the last God. How many live shows have I done?
All right,
5,555.
Marcy is probably yelling at the screen. More Harlan, damn it! What are you doing?
Cursing you right now.
Sorry, Marcy.
Damn you, Scott.
You know, sent the man home when I didn't get him out.
I'm back.
He's back.
I'm back.
I'm trying to think. What else? Okay. Okay, so here's your warning right now. If you're sensitive, if you're easily offended, and please, for the next 3 or 4 minutes, please do not watch.
Oh my God. Am I in this?
No, you're not in this.
Oh, so okay.
I'm in the one of the estate sales. I'm looking at
you're afraid of Harlan.
I'm looking at the books on one of the estate sales. That's a book at the estate sale.
Why do you even name it that? I don't understand.
I mean, that's,
to sell more books.
Sell more books.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
I didn't see it. So we get back in the van. Scott said, "Look what was in the estate sale." I said, "And you didn't buy that? What were you thinking?" Come on.
I should have bought that. Wolfman's Goodies, thank you so much for the super chat. Said he has What's Soul videos. Nice. Check them out. If you're looking for, if you're a fan of What's Soul videos, check out Wolfman.
Check them out.
Wolfman
coming at you.
That book. did I take a picture of anything else today? I try to take a picture of the interesting stuff because you don't have to send it. Joni doesn't go to yards, so I have to send this shit to Joni. She's like, Harlan, are you really sending that to Joni? You're damn right. And Joni.
And what response? What response did you get?
I don't think I got any response.
Come on.
I got the crying emojis. Where are y'all now? Estate sales on Bailey Cove.
It's cold out here.
Chilling still.
How to walk your dog? Yeah, that's a good one. All right, so from now on, Harlan, if I see stuff like that, I'll buy it.
You might as well. You could at least do a video on it.
And my thought was that I can't sell that at Van Mass because John would get offended and I'd just lose my $2.
I was gonna say then you'd have to eat it, but that wouldn't sound very good. Sorry. Okay, I need my coat.
Dear Lord, baby Jesus, we apologize. So Harlan and I, the auction that we sell at, a lot of really good people up there, and John does a really nice job of curating. So he doesn't allow, if it's borderline fringe, and I 100% agree with him that he's got to protect that auction. And so as he goes around, he numbers every item for the most part, so he'll see all the items. And so if it's something that's questionable, he doesn't allow it to be in the auction. So
it's really not a lot that you can't do. I mean.
Yeah, most sellers know that John's done a pretty good job of telling people, so most sellers know what they can't get.
Yeah, I mean, you can sell beer signs and all that kind of stuff. It's just the stuff, stuff that could be sexual or something like that. I don't know that. I couldn't believe this Scott spreader thing today was that much. I knew it was going to be a lot, but.
Yeah, he picked that. What'd you pay, $5 for it?
$5 for, I don't know if you can see that or not.
So it's the Scott's Elite spreader. So it's the double spreader. Wow. Yeah, he paid $5 for that thing today.
$5. I looked them up. They sell for $130 on Lowe's, Amazon, and Home Depot. It's like, wow. That was the lady who had the love steps. That was her most expensive thing in the whole yard sale.
No, I paid $5 for the water distiller.
Oh, that's right. Well, still $5 most expensive.
Yeah, so
everything.
If they paid over $100 for it, we had to pay $5. Yeah.
Everything else was $1. Right.
Well, especially if he priced it $1.
I told him about how many times did he get in trouble for shit he drug out to the? She talking about, I gave you that for Father's Day.
Oh, it was Andrew. Yeah. I gave you this for. And he just said, oh, I never got a chance to use it. So she goes, and you snuck it out here. I said, come on, Andrew.
Man, I regret not having a camera on today.
That would have been a good one.
That was yard sale gold right there. Oh my.
I said at least you didn't use your first, middle, and last name. You really know you've been in trouble, man.
Yeah, and I can't. There was one other one. I can't tell that joke though. In case they ever watch. About somebody's age. Oh my god.
Uh-huh.
Terrible, terrible. All right, so for last year, yard sales, they had wildfires in Canada. This year, earthquakes. I don't know. I guess we might have to go to a yard sales in a tornado. We've been in rain and everything else. No worries. I'm telling you right now, when things get tough with yard sales, go. If it's raining, if it's storming, if it's whatever, everybody else quit. Go. I'm telling you.
Be even cheaper because they're more desperate to get rid of it.
How many hummingbird feeders do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So was it 2 weeks ago you were out of town?
Yeah. Oh my God. I that's why I'm not going out of town anymore on Friday and Saturday, because 2 weeks ago I missed the yard sale of the century.
So I got up and there was only three listed. And I said, should I go? And it's like, you know what? Why do I keep saying this? Every time we say, should we go? And then we go, we find all kind of stuff. So I go, Scott's off some other state. So I go, it's on the other side of town. It's about a 30-minute drive. So I go and I get there. First one there, you know, second place is last place. So I get there and I end up buying like 50 items for like $57. I do really well. And we add it up and it's like 57. So I get my wallet out and I'm about probably 30 yards from the main road, standing in her driveway. And we hear this car just lock its brakes down, screeching, squealing, coming in. And I turn around and there's a woman sitting in the road with a blinker on, ready to turn into this lady's yard sale in her driveway. And this woman comes in and hits her, I mean, so hard, probably hits her 45 miles an hour still after sliding, hits her, knocks her forward into oncoming traffic, hits a car head on coming the other way. And this is all like 30 yards from me. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this woman, the lady that hit her was probably in her 70s, a black lady. She gets out. She said, I'm okay, everybody. I'm okay. Sorry I hit you, ma'am. And this other lady's got out of her car. She's collapsed into the grass. And a can falls out of her car. She kicks it under the car. And it's like, Mike's Hard Lemonade. That's awesome. So, so everybody gets there and they're checking her out. And the cops get there. And so I said, hey, this is what happened. She hit her into here. And when she got out, a can fell. She kicked under her car. You might want to look at that can. He said, thank you. Hey, she almost killed that lady. It's like, you ain't getting away scot-free.
Hey, Michigan girl. Good evening. How are you? And then he goes to the – so we have a group chat, but there's about 5 or 6 of us guys in there, of the yard sale guys who we used to go – the chat started out as we used to – where we were going to eat on Friday nights. Kevin Tyree, Harlan's brother, was the kind of the glue of that group, and he always got us together. We are always – but since he's passed, we still have that text group. And one of the guys goes – there's a huge yard sale / estate sale, and they are giving it away. And so Harlan goes over there. And for how many hours were you there total?
The first time I went, I was there 3 hours, but I was headed there already. I was en route after I directed traffic for like 15 minutes from the wreck. And he says, there's a guy in the garage, there's a lady inside the house, and there's a lady upstairs in a tie-dyed shirt. Nobody's making prices. You have to tell them kind of what you want to pay. And I'm like, things just got really cheap after hearing that. So I went upstairs and they had just shelves full of DVDs. Most of it was sets and stuff. Let me see. My phone's going to die. I mean, tons of stuff. I forgot what that one set was.
I talked to Mike times, and I'm like, he calls me at 4 o'clock. He's like, I have just finished getting everything. How many truckloads?
MacGyver. There's just Stargate, 10 seasons of Stargate, Secret Age. I mean, there's just tons of stuff everywhere. So anyway, I paid $20 for two huge boxes of that.
Is Marcia allowed to see the mess in your house?
Oh yeah, she's been over here. But I got 20, and that was an old. I got an old timey camera and an old radio. That was. I just went around and it started off on a dollar here.
Was it?
So Larry, two truck loads later.
Larry, way out. Hey, good evening, sir. If you don't want to meet me and you don't want to meet Harlan and you don't want to meet Marcia or Tracy or Joni or Jennifer, come to see Larry. Larry Wayout will be at Nashville.
Hey, this is South Carolina win, I guess it is.
We're taking over Nashville.
I think the other game's coming on. Who? Oh.
What's up, Dylan?
Oh, sorry, he's gone. Yeah, the big ball game comes on in just a minute.
What big ball game is that?
UConn and Iowa. This is, do you know the women's Final Four tickets are more expensive than the men's?
Wow.
This is this game. Caitlin Clark and Paige Buchers is next.
Yeah, they want to see Iowa. Iowa makes it because, you know, she's got to be the greatest women's player ever to play.
Yeah. And then you got UConn, you got Paige Buchers. So it's Paige versus Caitlin is what everybody's saying. So, ooh, boy, I had 1% left on my phone.
Safe! Hey, Marcia, when are you going to get this man an iPhone? Tell him to get rid of these Android phones he carries.
I can't bring the chat up. I'm going to try to bring it up again. I may get kicked out. Let me try.
That's your next challenge, Marcia, is to get Harlan to have an iPhone. Man. And not have a screen that's cracked. He's had a cracked screen for like the last 4 years.
You still have that S10 Plus?
No, he's got an S22, but he cracked it.
It wasn't that one.
Join the chat. Connect.
I'm telling you,
Verizon just wanted to screw me over when I was going to switch to the new iPhone.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, but you're not moving.
So every time I leave the screen, it locks me out. I can't look at the comments.
We can hear you, but
nobody's talking. They're in shock about the deal that you got for two truckloads. So Tracy's in the chat. Tracy, tell them how long you were at that same yard sale. Tell them how long you were there. You were there for what, an hour, 2 hours? We've got another friend named Duck. Duck spent, what, $700? Duck comes up to Harlan, talks about, you've missed it. And Harlan's like, dude, I got two truckloads.
Yeah, but he was buying big stuff. He buys refrigerators and washers and dryers and all that stuff. And
so Tracy was there an hour and a half, folks. And that's the thing that you know, they're like, how can Harlan and Scott go through the same yards? We buy completely different stuff. They wash it. We don't buy the same stuff. We both look at completely different. But you know, our buddy Duck buys the craziest stuff. Every now and then we'll see something and we go, man, I wish I got that. But for the most part, the stuff that we don't want to deal with, he buys. We buy such. Okay, I'm going to let y'all in on a secret. I've told y'all this secret before. Duck used to own a thrift store. Duck used to buy lockers. Duck used to sell everything Dusty ever bought. he was Dusty's secret source. Dusty. Okay, so this is how you treat friends. Have you ever seen Duck in one of my videos? If Duck showed up at a yard sale that I was videoing at, I turned the camera off out of respect to Dusty. so that he would never be in a video. No, there was never a chance you'd ever see Duck in a video.
He didn't want to be in a video?
I didn't want him to be in one in case somebody could ever put the connection together that Dusty bought so much stuff from him.
Oh, I got you.
Yeah, Duck is the one who bought that. Remember the one, the furry one? That Duck bought that estate, and Dusty bought all that furry stuff from Duck.
Say furries?
What kind of furries you talking about?
Remember the furry?
That kind.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
Was Marcy?
Oh, I apologize.
Marcy and I are supposed to know about this one.
Do what?
Sorry, Marcia, you're not supposed to know about furries.
Even the Amish guy knows what that is.
Harley's phone's about to start blowing up.
What is this? What the hell is this?
So if y'all didn't follow Dusty Alabama Pickers, he had a lot of stuff from a guy when he passed away. His estate. He was the organizer of the furry convention of Huntsville. And the entire basement was full of this stuff about furries.
Oh, are you serious?
Did you not see all that stuff Dusty had about?
Oh, no. I was just trying to be funny, but looks like I just jumped right into that one, didn't I?
No,
I didn't know.
From magazines to costumes to everything. Dusty.
Really?
It was crazy.
Wow. No, I never knew that.
Yeah, no, he. So did Dusty sell the barber chair? He did sell the barber chair.
That thing was, went away about 4 tons. I moved it once.
And I moved it once. It was such.
Golly.
We had to move it out of the way. That was the night that we were out there shooting guns and fireworks in front of his building on the highway.
Oh my gosh.
That was stupid. I don't recommend that.
I don't recommend it.
So me, Dusty, and Big Jim. Y'all remember Big Jim? Jim now lives in Delaware. He's back up with his people. He's a liberal, but Jim's a nice guy. I never had any problems with Jim. Jim was always, we just never talked politics because, you know, when two people, I was crazy about politics back then. I'm not anymore. But, so we went to an auction, a live auction, somewhere in Alabama, somewhere over in Fort Payne, Alabama. Me and Dusty bought fireworks. And so we shot these fireworks off. And then we decided, you know, let's shoot our guns.
Because what could go wrong?
We've gotten this far. Why not?
Yeah.
We get this far. A lot of Andrews say.
That was an interesting night.
Did the cops come? You just got quiet after I asked that.
So Mother's Mustache says, Harlan, stop playing. You remember the furry state. You got your donkey tail in the ear from it.
If I wore that in Vegas, I was really messed up because I don't think I've ever owned anything like that.
You don't remember that?
I don't remember that.
There was that one night in Vegas you were really fucked up.
Shh.
I've seen it. You're talking about 2019 or the after that?
It was after that. No, 2019 was the year I was really fucked up in Vegas.
2019 wasn't bad for me. 2021? Was it 2021?
2021. Or
2 or 1.
No, last year.
Yeah, last year would have been 2023.
No, it was 2020. It's
2022.
Because you didn't go last year. I was really good last year.
All I'm gonna say is when you're so drunk and throwing up in a casino, the hotel security has to, on your anniversary, has to wheelchair you up to your room and give you to your wife. I don't recommend any of that.
You know what's funny about that story is right before I left to go to Vegas, me and Marcia we talked, and you know, we're a couple, you know. She was telling her friend, she said, "Who does that before you go to Vegas?" She said, he said he made sure we were officially a couple before we went to Vegas. It's like, yeah, baby.
Marcia, I've seen him drunk as a skunk, profess his love to somebody and never remember it. So you remember that. I've seen him drunk tell everybody around that he loves this lady. And yeah. Dave, am I lying, Dave?
Nope. Oh, I've seen it.
Y'all are fired. When you get drunk, you don't know what you're talking about. I don't remember anything. That was the first time I had been like that. And yeah, that was that's not recommended.
I learned my lesson from mixing alcohol and weed in 2019, whenever that unfortunate incident happened, where I had to be wheeled to my room. So Dave and I decided we were just gonna get high as fuck and sit there and watch everything that night. And we watched Harlan.
A little drinking.
So we had friends show up and they started giving out free alcohol. And you got to take free alcohol. You got to take free shots.
That's the problem with that. Everybody's buying you drinks.
It's an unwritten rule. Like, well, I don't remember taking the free shots. I was already in bad shape before I got the free shots.
Is that video still on your channel where we were?
Oh, wait. That's 2019. And yeah. You talking about that one?
Is the 2019
2019 was the one where they had the rows and rows of whatever that slushy stuff was.
Oh my god, that slushy stuff kicked my ass. That shit kicked my ass.
That was the lady.
We went to the tiki bar.
Yeah,
I had the drink called the zombie. Mm-hmm. I don't remember much after that.
That's because you had two more of those slushies.
Man, Shane,
I don't remember that.
I'm like, Shane, what are you drinking? Shane's like, over there, the slushy. Make sure you tell him to put some Crown in. I'm like, all right. She's like, you want a double? I'm like, go double in it. It was 10% already, and I threw a double Crown in it.
It already had Crown in it.
So, Marcia, go back and look at our channel. There's one on there where it's just an hour of, I got to pee. I got to pee. Oh my
man, I'm already getting texts already, y'all. So that's
that was a night there were like nine people in my van. We were so drunk that Big John had to drive us back to the hotel. And yep. There's a couple of those little exits where you do the big circles on them, and Harlan's sitting in the middle of Harlan goes, "Can you please find some straight roads back to the hotel?"
was that when Grumpy John had to drive us back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, Scott, I think I have video footage from 2022 that I forgot about.
Hey, now. Hey, now.
He said, take it easy. Yeah.
If I've got video footage, I know bro code. I just lost. It just accidentally got deleted. I don't know what happened.
What happened?
I blame it on Jameson, Philippi, and Steve Rakin. That's what I'm going to Rakin profit. I'm going to blame it on them.
It was definitely, he was the one buying the drinks for sure.
I just remember at one point looking down and I had a drink in my hand. It's like, well, I didn't order this. I don't know where this came from.
Wade was doing that shit too.
I may have got one from Wade too.
Yeah, Wade was getting people fucking ripped.
That's not the year that he got the stretch limo or SUV, was it? Was that a different year?
That was the first year, yeah.
The first year, okay. Yeah, I remember that.
I'm telling you, he was getting people fucking wrecked.
Yeah.
See, this is why you resell, so you can have all this fun. I'm telling you, folks, it's make friends reselling. The memories are.
You know what? Those I've been to every year to the one out in Vegas, the one that they've done. And that is fun. And it's, you know, hanging around, you know, like-minded people and stuff. That's so much fun. You don't have to go out there and have a whole lot of fun, too much fun.
Yeah, I'm bummed I missed last year.
See, I was good last year. I drank. Everybody come up to me and they said, "You're not drinking this year." And I said, "I know. I'm being good this year.
You don't have any bad influences around either."
Yeah, that's what's the common denominator.
For the record, I was a good influence in 2022. I got you back to your room. Yeah. I swore after I had to be wheelchaired up, I was never going to be that way again.
God.
Because Harlan had changed in our room, and he's running around in his little Officer Dangle outfit. He called trying to get me, and somebody else answered my phone. He's like, "Yeah, they're wheeling Scott up there right now." And
I had just talked to you, and you're like, "Yeah, we'll be out in just a minute." And we stood right outside the entrance of, what was that place? Oh, House of Blues in Mandalay Bay. Yeah. We were standing right up there, and I'm like, he never came out. I've watched the door. called, nothing. Finally, Barry Burleson, Thrifty Santa, answered the phone. He goes, "Hey," and I'm like, "What's going on?" He goes, "Well, Scott just started projectile vomiting everywhere in here, and now he's in a wheelchair, and security is taking him to the room." And I look down this long hallway, and there he goes. And yeah, we got him up to the room and scared Joni to death. She was asleep.
Joni tells me the next morning, because that was our anniversary. I don't know what anniversary that was. We were married in 91. That happened in 2019. So y'all do the math. And she's like, "They got you up there and you're drunk ass and you're still throwing up and they're trying to tell me about some of your health conditions, a high blood pressure and this and that." And she said, "I looked at them fuckers and I said, I've been married to this asshole for the last 25 years. I fucking know what's wrong with his ass."
You remember we had nice to call the hotel to ring the room just to wake her up so she don't lock the door.
Because so that I had got us a good room, so everything happened in, is it Mandalay Bay? Everything was happening in, but we were staying in the Delano because you get a suite in the Delano, so we had the connected. We had the suite that had like a bath. It had a bath and a half in it. All this crap. I am never ever waking up again where my beard smells like vomit.
Oh my gosh.
Never.
You know, the funniest part about that trip is they said, "You know, this is it's a costume party." So, and what was it, 80s, 90s, I think? Because they had an 80s band and a 90s band playing.
As though they were on four different floors. Each one.
Yeah, they had different floors. So yeah, I mean, like you know, I'm gonna wear Lieutenant Dangle. I'm just gonna wear this. I'm just gonna rock this thing out. We walk up to the line, and it's like, why is nobody but me hardly wearing a costume? I mean, maybe 5% of the people were wearing a costume, and I'm like, "Yo, I gotta go change." And they're like, "No, you're gonna rock this party. You're gonna rock this party." And oh my gosh!
Hey, tell them about the two gay guys.
Oh yeah, so we're on a dance floor. I think it's on the 80s floor or something. The band says we're gonna take a break. We'll be back in a little bit. And you know, everybody starts walking, and I feel somebody tap me on the shoulder, and I turn around. This guy said, "Shut the fuck up." I love it. I said, "Thank you." I just walked off, kept on walking. I said, I guess I did good. I don't know.
And so there's some pictures of Harlan in his little outfit there. And Joni comes up to me, and we're sitting in one of these little and because you had to eat like in like a little balcony area where you can see everything. And he's like, so-and-so just came up and said that if Harlan lived near her, he would be hers.
That's nasty.
I can't tell you.
Hey, I just found the lid to that big water jug, Scott, that we was looking for today.
Hey, you're missing the part. There's a rubber ring that it sits on.
Yeah. You found that?
Man.
Okay.
I put two boxes back in there. It's in the box on your side, and you'll be filling up. So.
Okay, cool. So you are exactly right. So here's the thing. Okay. I told, like, today, me and Scott's like, you know, there's not many yard sales. We're not going to find a lot of stuff. So I was telling my girlfriend, and she said, why are you so negative? You can't be negative. You got to go into this saying, it's going to be a great day. We're going to find good stuff. So tomorrow, we're going to dominate. We're going to fill the van up.
Did she listen to some more Rob Dahl after we talked to her? You talked to her?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Man, because she listens to a lot of podcasts. And Harlan shows her one, and she was watching a podcast with Rob Dahl on it, and it was somebody else's podcast. I'm like, I listen to Rob Dahl like three or four times a week. I love Rob Dahl. He is a great motivational guy. He explains stuff on a simple level for my simple mind.
Simple minds. So tomorrow we are going to dominate out of the gate.
Tracy, we're going to kick so much ass, you might as well stay at home. So we get there today 30 minutes early because we decided that we did not get there fat early enough last year. So we're going to show up earlier. The early bird and the worm and all that fun stuff. And one of our guys that we know who we see all the time gets out behind us. And I open the van. I'm like, it's 30 minutes early. Get back in the car. And he said, they let me in early last year. I'm like, well, shit, they let us out. Let's go early this year. So we had already, by the time Tracy got there, we'd already been there like 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was 6:29, right at 6:30. Yeah, and we went in and them women's prices were nuts. They were either completely insane or that's a great deal, but most of them were like crazy.
She looked up something and she said, well, on eBay, she says, I'm going to say $100. And I looked right at her and go, well, I'm going to say I have to pass.
She had an Xbox guitar and drum set. And I said, how much is that? She goes, well, on eBay, it's $100, so it's only $80. And they put a hold on it. And I'm like, don't put that hold on there for me. She goes, you don't want it? And I'm like, no, I don't.
I mean, I was in for 10.
Yeah, maybe 10. That's it. Oh, 80? No, thanks.
Yeah, we still bought several good things there. Only 80, yeah. Ansley, only 80. I'm telling you got to have your own yard sale stories. Man, it never ceases to amaze me the fun we have at yard sales and the cool people we meet. That's the whole thing about yard sales, man. You meet some of the most fun, cool people.
And the way you do that, makes you talk to people when you go to sale. Some people won't even say anything.
I was actually talking to people. And I don't even like it's like we've got quite a bunch of coffee makers. I'm like, how much is this one? She's like, well, this one is 8 and this one is 10. I'm like, how much is this one? And she's like, it's got a price on it. And we're looking all around and she's like, it don't have a price on it. I'm like, how much is this one? I'll take 10 for that one too. Okay. 10. Yeah, she had that lady priced good. It's the other lady that was crazy.
Yeah.
And then me and Tracy are in there going, in the garage. They had all these electronics and stuff there with this box full of shoes. And me and Tracy had then divided up these shoes. I had like four pairs and Tracy had three. And we're like, how much are the shoes again? And the lady comes in there and goes, those are her husband's shoes. Those are not for sale. We had all this lady's husband.
I saw that. That was funny.
It was all Tracy's fault because Tracy started grabbing them. I'm like, I'm not gonna be left out. I'm grabbing some too.
And then she said, "I said, how much are all the clothes? Clothes are $2. Wait, no, they're a dollar. Nope, I'm sorry, they're a dollar." And I said, "Okay." She goes, "Wait, hold on. No, I'm sorry, they're $2." And I said, "Really? I mean, they were kind of disorganized for a while."
Yeah, it was a charity. They were raising money to send people to where?
They send money to a
Uganda or somewhere
in Uganda. It's a village. They send money to a village in Uganda, and then the kids had written little cards and stuff, thanking you and stuff like that. I think it was their what, sixth or seventh year to do that, I believe.
I got a text. Is that from right now, Jacob?
Yeah, I took that this evening. Been working on it all week.
Damn, you do good work.
What do you do?
It's a picture of his hotel building that he's redone. So how many of those units? That unit's out of. That's cardboard.
Yeah, that's the four of the six are finished, completely finished.
Is that the one with the fountain in the courtyard?
No, not the fountain. No, not that one.
You say four out of six are done?
Yeah.
Nice. Very nice.
It's hard to see. The slum lord is working along.
It's working, man.
Let's see if I can make it
show up a little better. The fountain one, is that, that's the Airbnb, right?
So, yeah, these are the short-term rental Airbnbs. Let's see if it'll show up here. I don't know. It don't show up much better here. Yeah.
Did you have to zone those different? How do they do that in your area?
So, luckily, it was already zoned multifamily because it had been ran as an efficiency right after the motel was closed. Here's a daytime one. Okay. It's easier to see.
That's cool.
So, do you rent by the hour?
Yeah. By the minute, by the hour, by the decade.
Jennifer wants to know, are there any updates on the guy that was driving you crazy last week?
Off the record, yeah. What the building looked like way back when? Here you go.
Oh, that's cool.
That was when it was by the hour.
Yeah.
Yep. And for anybody who knows what a pulsarhythm mattress is, I don't know, but you can tell me. Something about putting quarters in it.
When you put the quarter in, it vibrates.
I don't think so. I'm not sure.
I think that's what those are.
But you can see, here's the name of what the motel's name was.
Somatic. That's awesome.
Right, yeah, that's so that's the so this is actually, this picture is actually a picture of a postcard.
I'm gonna check my text right quick. I'll probably get kicked out, so I'm gonna have to come back in.
What?
All right. Make sure you know the password.
I know, right? So what is that?
So that's one of the other buildings that I own as well on the same property.
What are you doing with that one?
It's the one I'm sitting in right now.
Oh, okay.
So he's made them all apartments,
basically.
Efficiency apartments. Yeah.
Yeah.
So the motel are efficiency apartments, and then there's nine regular one bedroom, or eight regular one bedroom apartments, and one of them is a two bedroom. So nine apartments in that building. And then if you look at this building right over here. It looks more like a house. It's got three apartments in it.
Tom Higgins, so Jacob will tell you early on when he got kicked off the Amish plantation, he read Rich Dad Poor Dad and took it to heart. I'm telling you right now, you know, I've been reading books, trying to develop the business, more of my business thought and business. And it's really changes the way you think. So I challenge you, the books that I've been reading, I challenge each one of you, you know, Profit First is a really good one. Rich Dad Poor Dad is a must read. Really, really get you thinking way different. Even the one we're doing now, we'll do it next Monday night. Blue Ocean Strategies. I challenge you to, you know, it's easy to sit here and get caught up in watching resellers, you know, watch people complain about whatever, you know, and show you, you know, I found the latest Holy Grail. I did this, I did that. But, you know, you're the business owner. You're the business strategist. You're not just a sourcer. You're not just a lister. You're not just a shipper. You're also the person who runs your business. And so you need to, you know, engage your mind with different thought. So I challenge you. I'm trying to read three books a month. Right now I'm a book behind this month, so I need to catch up. So next week on the road, I will be listening to books and no more country music and no more 3 Days Grace. I've got to catch up on my book to hit my target of three books a month. Find a podcast that you like, something that really challenges you. I've been listening to some more equity and stock guys podcast talking about that. I've been listening. I love Rob Dial. I listen to him three times a week usually. You know, develop the business part of your mind. You can always, and we always concentrate on what's eBay doing. That stuff's the easy stuff. The hard stuff is how do you differentiate yourself from someone else? And from other sellers, you need to be a better business person, a better strategist. You need to be more efficient. You need to look at your business with an open mind. A challenger. So Mr. Sadie says, when Joni kicks Scott, Jake has him covered. Larry, you realize we've been together since 1988. I don't think that's going to could be wrong, but if Joni leaves, I'm just packing a bag and going with her, so it doesn't matter.
Right? There's no getting rid of me.
You know what you're talking about. Ron said he's reading that book for the fifth time. It truly, don't skip the book about cooking cock. Yeah, that's not a good one. Cassie, that's wonderful. 50% of a draw from the profit account for the first quarter and an extra mortgage payment. That is absolutely amazing. Larry, you've known me for some time now. You know I'm too lazy. I don't know how I'm an introvert and shy, and I don't know how I ever asked Joni out to begin with and how I ever made that work. But, yeah, I'm not doing that again. I'm good.
Do you remember how?
Am I going to read any Dave Ramsey books? I don't have him on the list. It's because you see Harlan with a mustache in one of those books. Marcia, are you still with us? You realize there's a picture of Harlan. This used to be his contact picture on my phone. Let me find it. Of Harlan with his porn stash.
Yeah, that's a good one.
So he's in a Dave Ramsey. He used to teach Dave Ramsey. I'm gonna find that for you. Yeah. I know you're not gonna comment in the chat, but I'm gonna send it to you.
Well, while you work on that,
I'm looking right now. There are too many Jonies, and when she was in like the second grade, the fourth grade. Come on, man.
Oh,
All right, let's edit this picture.
Wow.
Marcia, are you watching? Shake your head yes.
Yeah.
I know you want a copy of this. That's awesome. But it's but I'm telling you guys, it's how do you make this for the long term? You know, we have a lot of fun on Friday nights. Friday nights, if you got a question, I'll answer anything I can tell you about reselling, if I can help you out. But it's, I challenge you this year for me is to work on me and the business me. I know enough about reselling to get by. I've been reselling full time for the last, since 2013. So this is year number 11. I don't have any problem. I really think the first 10 years I was a high functioning hobbyist, and I want to move into a business owner and function much more as a business person, even though I know I've still created myself a job and I'm all right with that. It's what I do with the business aspect of it, where I effectively manage my money better and track my numbers and can really talk more about the numbers instead of just by the seat of my pants. And so I challenge you, find someone to listen to, whatever books it is, podcast, something that challenges you. You know, get friends around you that have the same goals. You know, Mr. I'm on the phone down there is super smart for an almost 40-year-old, impressive young man. So I challenge you to get people around you that can push you. Dave's reaction to Harlan's picture is priceless.
Well, I have been drinking, so.
Yeah. I have to get up early. Harlan is actually showing up at 5:30. So yeah, we're gonna hit yard sales early tomorrow.
Wow.
Jake's on the phone talking with Elon.
He's like, buy, sell.
Yeah.
Buy. No, sell, sell.
Yeah, I missed John tonight. So yeah, we did the podcast Wednesday. So if y'all didn't see John, he was live last night. They were talking taxes. Yeah, I don't talk much taxes. It's
you don't like accounting.
No, I've got an accounting degree. That's enough. But there, I can tell you to find somebody smarter than you to do your taxes. That's what I can tell you.
Right? Pay the money.
Taking over my payroll and a lot of the accounting work of my accounting, because Johnny also has an accounting background, so she's doing our accounting, the legwork of it, and then we'll have Jake we'll have our accountant do the year end. Yep. Mr. Say just got home from the tax lady. Jason pulled an extension for the third year. Nice.
Yeah. What are you gonna do? I used to do all my own taxes for years and years and years, and then.
So William asked, "What's the farthest you'll travel for yard sales?" We're very blessed here that Huntsville generally has quite a few yard sales. So when I used to travel, you can use the apps, Yard Sale Treasure Map and GSeller are the ones that I use. Anywhere you're at, they'll give you yard sales. And so when I was last week, when Harlan was carrying on loading up his truck 10 times, I hit a couple of yard sales on the way back. I started in Columbus, Georgia. I think I had 3 yard sales down there. They weren't great, but they were yard sales. I've done yard sale. I lived in North Carolina. I've done them there. The 127, I've done. I've been to every, except for the last 40 miles into Michigan. I've not done that. But I've done all of the 127 except for the last 40. I'll do Ohio this year. I'm planning on starting in Cincinnati and going north. But there. So when my brother and I, the year that we did this stuff together, and we had a six-week California trip, we did estate sales all the way out there. We were doing estate sales in Wichita, Kansas. There's some crazy. I mean, it's amazing you find such different stuff in different areas.
Oh, Quash, he's back. Don't talk about him anymore.
That was my big order from Texas coming through.
What?
Yep.
What'd you order?
No. The guy ordering Willows. Oh. He's ordering for his big ranch. I think I talked to him about 3 or 4 weeks ago, and he wants them shipped out Monday. He's sending me a check by mail tomorrow.
You're sending out like a pallet of sticks?
Yeah. So I challenge you to do things differently. So one of my ideas this year is to, as I make yard sale videos, you know, a lot of people that watch the videos, I'm going to put some of the things up for sale on my website just to try that, see how that works. Inspired by Jennifer's one of my real close friends. One of the ladies she watches on Whatnot does that. And she's had a lot of success doing that. And she's got a lot less subscribers and views than I get, and had success selling on her website. So I'm like, you know what? How do you drive traffic? You know, show the merchandise in the video. They didn't put it up for sale. So gonna try some of that. I challenge you to try. Uh-oh. Oh Lord have mercy. She has showed her face. And she is blonde, just like in the picture. That really messed with me.
She's got two screens going. Wait a second. This happened and this is happening. Now I got to keep up. That's awesome.
Yeah. Marcia, I know the real stories, but some of the stories are not YouTube worthy.
Not YouTube friendly.
I can be bribed to be told in person, but yeah, bro code means that I can't tell it on YouTube. Yeah. I edited somebody out of that picture because there was another person in that picture. But it's. There's so many different ways to do this game, and you really got to figure out, you know, everybody goes, oh, but Beard, you and Harlan are so lucky y'all have that local auction. With the invention of Whatnot, man, I challenge you to look at Whatnot. You can do Whatnot. It's amazing the stuff that they're selling. Just go over there and look at some of these people and what they're selling and what, man, they're moving a lot of merchandise. Yeah, look at Dave up there in the corner. Anybody can turn the camera on. Dave's on. Come on, tell him, Dave.
Right.
People are. I understand, ladies. It's a little. You know, people might be a little meaner about looks, but the one thing I know in this life is you can't let fear of what others think or slow you down. You know, they're just haters. They're just jealous. The hell with us, folks. Do you really want to base your life and stop yourself because of the fear of what somebody behind the computer that you'll never meet thinks about you? I can tell you what I think about that person. Just don't give a fuck. Just don't. They have no effect on your life. The only effect they have is a negative effect if you allow it to happen. So whatever you decide to go for. I'm telling you right now, look at the people that are selling on Whatnot. They're selling everything. I think the future of reselling is going to involve a lot of social. I think that's going to be the change. Is Amazon going to change that much? No, they're going to take advantage of some of it. eBay will take advantage of some live auctions, but they'll be the same. But the new platforms that are coming, I think, will be a lot of social aspect to it. Eric, I challenge you to come on the show.
Come on, Eric.
Come hang out.
Michigan's girl sells on Whatnot, and all you see is the nice little nails.
Just the hands, right? Yeah, it works.
I've watched a couple of her shows.
Yeah.
Jennifer's going to sell on Whatnot.
Did Steve do his first show yet?
He's done two now.
He's done well. I watched the second one.
Steve did a nice show.
Yeah.
Pat D's. I bought stuff from Pat D's last week, and I'll watch him this week.
Yep.
It's about having, you just got to have a personality and be engaged and just talk to people. You know, treat people like they're real people.
Like Steve's got a good voice, you know, for it. It'll probably work well for him. He doesn't really have to even show himself. He can just show product, show his hands. Yeah. Engage.
Let Michigan Girl tell you how many items have you sold in that Michigan Girl? I've watched her sell little miniatures, and I don't want to be the one that has to pack all those miniatures, all that delicate stuff you sell. Mark says he's just one ass with an opinion. Yeah, I bought stuff from Pat the other day.
Yeah.
Eric, why would you be nervous? You just be yourself. Just talk. There's nobody going to reach in here and hurt you or do anything to you. I'm an introvert on the internet. God almighty. I don't talk to anybody in person. Just wait till... I'm telling you right now, come visit us in Nashville. We'd love to see you on the 26th or 28th. You better come talk to me because I ain't going to seek you out.
Right.
I am not going to seek you out.
I would say something.
I have been to too many events now, and Harlan has talked to everybody. He's like, did you meet so-and-so? I'm like, who?
Who?
No. I didn't meet any of them. Oh, God. What's up, Connie?
Challenge accepted.
Connie, I know you're a dude. Don't hand me no shit. Jennifer, my mother has so much Fenton. She loves milk glass. Oh, my God. All that damn white mess. She's got a whole house of it.
Is that the stuff that glows with a black light? What is that?
No, that's uranium glass.
There you go.
There. Fenton makes a lot of different stuff, but they do make a lot of the milk glass. That's the white stuff. And most likely we'll get to meet Swamp Picker. You'll get to meet Glenn.
I hope so.
Glenn's a really nice guy. Glenn might be chasing me around this time. If I don't put seats in the van, you might have to chase me, Glenn.
Yeah, Square's not bad.
I like it because they give you a free website. You don't really have to know anything. And Squarespace is fine, which is different. Square and Squarespace are not the same thing. Squarespace is more expensive. You don't have a free version, I don't think. Or if they do, it's pretty crappy. But the free version of Square is really good. So I'll put my link in there if anybody wants to use it to get free processing. Basically, you have $500 in free processing if you don't use the link, or you get $1,000 if you use the link.
Yeah, Joni went out there to look to see what I bought today, and she's like, oh, look at the Corningware. I'm like, no, let's not look at the Corningware, Miss Pyrex. And then Pamper Chef, that's what I was trying to think of earlier. Nobody came up with it. Pamper Chef, there's a big piece of stoneware, and she's like, oh, I want that. I'm like, man, I pay 50 cents for that. I definitely want that. I'm like, mm-hmm. Okay, you can have it. It's in the auction pile right now because last week she claimed part of my cast iron. Man.
Bargaining, aren't we, though?
Speaking of Pampered Chef, if you run across this brand, definitely don't look it over either. Don't overlook it.
I know a lot of the Pampered Chefs. Shit,
it's
stuff worth money.
I've never heard of licorice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Miss Queen laying in there. She's drugged me to their damn, because along the interstate, they have like outlet stores.
Uh-huh.
That's some, even in the outlet stores, that's some expensive shit.
Mm-hmm. I found this in an apartment after they moved out.
Yeah, so we are, Pamper Chef is getting sold, as long as she don't remember it, because she don't watch these videos, so I'm safe. on Monday, that stuff is going to the auction. And if she doesn't watch out, that cast iron is still sitting there on the table. If she don't move it, it's going to the auction too. And if she don't move, I'll send her ass to the auction. Yeah. Larry Halftime, it didn't even make. I bought so one of the yard sales we ran into was so don't discount couponers, folks. Couponers. Mm-hmm. So we ran into this yard sale. It was all couponers. You know, I scan. So I start looking at the table, start scanning. And so I bought $129 worth of stuff from the couponers. And there were some Neutrogena face masks of some sort. Man, Joni's already stole a face mask from me. Damn it.
I bet you can find some Starbucks mugs on her shelf.
Oh.
Sounds like an even trade to me.
Joni watching.
You got me thinking now.
Ooh. Tread lightly.
Sorry, Joni. I still love you.
She ain't watching. You're safe. I'm not going to
tell her. I am Margarita in Nashville.
I'm not going to tell her that Jacob's just sold her down the road.
Mm-hmm. No kind of inventory.
Hey, Ron, all that stuff goes to auction. I don't care. So I'm in. So this house is four bedrooms, but three bedrooms on this side. And our bedroom is back in the corner behind the kitchen. So she can't hear me in here. Have y'all not noticed? Phoebe's the only one been in here once. Franklin hadn't been in here. Yeah, she's not asleep. I heard her laughing a minute ago. She's not asleep. Larry, she's got her mom's. Her grandmother's pie safe in the freaking dining room, and it is completely full. The top, the bottom cabinets, and the top. It's all damn Starbucks mugs.
Yeah.
And half of them I bought and drug home whenever I've been traveling.
Yeah.
Yeah, my cover.
Tell her, okay, here's what you do. You tell her that you'll get her all of the new series.
Oh, trade out on a discovery. Hey,
so she'll finally be able to have a full set of all 50 states.
I don't think she cares. Yeah, I don't think she cares. Now I can hear the TV playing. She is not asleep. Although she didn't answer my last text.
She's ignoring you.
I know. But it also shows she didn't read it.
She saw the notification and she went,
whoop. It just says delivered. It doesn't say read.
Yeah, right. She's like, whoop.
So Ansley, Steve is Steve Alcorn on whatnot. Just yeah. I think it's just Steve Alcorn.
I think you got to search it.
Yeah, I think he did a good job, Steve.
I think he did.
Folks, it's the secret. There's a lot of secrets to it. Just send stuff, you know, talk to your audience, pay attention, you know, be pretty quick with your auctions because nobody wants, if you want to retain your audience, don't spend, you know, 3 or 4 minutes between auctions.
Yeah.
Damn, Jennifer sent me this chick. It says, watch this chick. Thank you. She is running. She'll be on there for three and a half hours.
For like a second, and then like bing.
And she'll run 1,000 items. She'll sell 1,000 items, folks.
That's insane. I mean,
she runs a lot of stuff, 5 seconds and sudden death.
Yep.
If they're more expensive, she'll push them up by 10 or 15 seconds. But that, thank you. Hey, guys, thank you. And she's running auction after auction after auction. I mean, people come back in the chat and go, you're still on? She is just blowing through items. She's barely holding them up there. She's just showing them. Yeah. It is absolutely. So there's.
There you go. Good. Yeah.
Ainsley, there's Steve. Jacob put you a link. He's Mr. Link for us. And she is and she's on live 3, 4, 5 times a week. I mean, she just think about that. If she's selling, we watched her for 45 minutes sell like 300 and some items. If she's selling that damn many, just think about what you could sell. Somebody's timer just went off.
Might be me.
Some beeper, and that ain't me.
Not me.
I have something in here that does that.
Somebody planted one of those random beepers in your your place.
They're listening.
I can't remember her name, Ron. ask Jennifer. She's still here. Jennifer, what's that girl's name? Something Luck, or I don't know what her name is. She's live right now. SoCal Love One. SoCal Love One. She's got 200 people watching.
How many people watching?
200.
200, yeah.
See the sudden death?
Yep.
There it goes. That thing is at $39. She's flying through this thing.
Yeah, watch a guy that does this with a perfume.
So, guys, brand new, 2 seconds.
Yeah. Thanks for it.
Okay. I don't know if I'm doing it wrong, guys. If I am doing it wrong, I'm so sorry. Thank you so much. That's all you
have. Thank you. I mean, she is good. I mean, really good.
She has somebody running the buttons on the, you know, clicking the buttons. Right?
Some of us are asking for the Jeffree Star lipsticks. I have bundled like this for Jeffree Star lipsticks. These are the Velour ones. Let me check out what they look like. I love these. But I'm doing a bundle for you guys.
141 items so far on that lot.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
So I'm doing bundles of 4 lipsticks for you guys. And trying to do mixed colors and all them, guys. But the colors are so pretty.
Guys.
This one's in the shape of paleontologist. So pretty. Okay.
Light. There she goes.
Here, guys, check out this bundle of 4, guys. Here goes. Bundle of 4 is the nice 4
Jeffree. It's already running in sudden death.
Beautiful colors
tonight.
Right now,
and it's gone. That's auction's over with. And she's running another right now. Watch. There goes another one. Same thing. Thank you.
They're smart. They do like
giveaways the whole time.
You know, if you look, she's doing a giveaway like.
Yeah.
Back to back, and they keep the people in. People get free shipping, then they buy shit.
2 seconds.
And she's running another one. I'm telling you, man, she's just running. Ray Kane, get ready for it. Hey, thanks for joining us, Ray Cone. I got your name wrong the first time. John, what's man? She sells. I mean, it's just you see how she picked up the next item, and she's got multiples of that item, and she's just she's running them 10 seconds, 5 seconds, sudden death. And if you watch her, she'll have the same people buying over and over and over and over. It's, but she's got help. She's got somebody running the computer side and she puts it up there and it just goes.
I'm gonna guess she has at least two people running the back part of it. Is my
she gotta have people help her ship. I mean, she'll sell 1,000 items tonight. 1,000 items.
Yeah, no, it's insane. And
I'm telling you, there's a way to do all this. You know, reselling. Think outside the box. Think about what you're good at, what you want to do. What don't be scared to try it. You know, most of the time people are so concerned about returns and all this other crazy shit. Whenever it's you don't have any money in a lot of this stuff. I mean, I filled up a quarter of my van today. I didn't even spend $100. And I've got one item that's worth $200. Oh, yeah. Johnny's not asleep. She's taking the dogs out. How come you're ignoring me, damn it? I'm live, by the way.
What up?
What's up?
Hey, Johnny.
Hello.
What's really going on?
Three more weeks and you get to see me again.
Yay! Who is Kent Daigle and why did they say Adderall? Hey, I love me some Addies. I've got ADHD.
Everything that's going on.
Kent is a Cajun. He don't know any better. Tracy says hilarious. Hello.
Hey, Tracy. You've got to get your elephant hung.
Come here, Franklin.
Not you were hung like an elephant.
Come here, Franklin.
I thought you
insulted. Hey, Frank, you want to say tell everybody hello?
Hello, everyone. It's Franklin. I think you missed my boy.
I like you, everybody. Unlike my girlfriend who hates everybody. Oh, yeah, she has to go get Dixie Belle. Dixie Belle's probably stuck outside.
Stuck.
Oh, she's on the bed. Can't get off the bed.
You might need to use those steps.
Yeah.
there's a ramp to the bed for the dogs.
Oh.
There ain't no mistaking that ramp for anything else but a ramp. So this morning I said, this is Franklin is so damn crazy. I get up this morning, it's 5 o'clock and I'm about to go in and take medicine, take a shower, and Franklin wakes up. Franklin's wandering around the bed. Franklin goes through the steps, so they're like the steps, so they've got like out indoor outdoor carpet on them going down because we have a Tempur-Pedic bed, so it's kind of high. Franklin gets to the top of the ramp and just slides down it. I'm like, Did your penis itch or something? Did you just drug yourself and your dog penis and your dog balls down the ramp? I'm like, I don't know. Whenever my day started out with Franklin just rubbing his junk down the ramp, that it was just going to go straight to hell from the rest of the day. He'll blow a mountain picker. Hey man, good evening, whatever the hell this is. Yeah, I've had too much. I've already refilled this. Dave, are you out yet?
Done. I damn squeezed it. Every drop I could. Look. Yeah, it's no more.
Yeah, it's Ainsley, I'm telling Franklin's a man. If you hadn't seen Franklin, that is the craziest dog. Phoebe's just mad at the world and carries on and hates everybody. Franklin's nuts. He's absolutely insane. I look outside and it's cold today. He's outside laying in the grass by himself. When Phoebe comes outside, he runs to the fence, turns around and looks at her because he doesn't bark hardly at all. He wants Phoebe to bark at the dog next door while he runs up. And if Phoebe doesn't come over there, he'll just, it's almost like he shrugs his shoulders. He'll pee on the fence and then he'll leave.
Take that.
That is the craziest. Yeah, it's going to be 35 in the morning when we wake up. I think the high tomorrow is only like 62. Tomorrow, 63. It's going to be 34 in the morning. Yeah, I don't do Addies. Well, I do Mr. Sadie, but God, those damn things make me bounce off walls. Oh my God.
Probably barely need half of one.
Okay, I get a lot of stuff done because the voices in my head all, instead of having like 10 or 11 things going on at one time, they all focus on one thing. And so, yeah, if I take an Adderall, I'm going to take half. I'll be so tired when it wears off that I'm like, yeah, I'll take a half. But yes, Johnny and her Adderall.
Crown Royal and Adderall.
Sell the empties on eBay. Is anybody buying these things, Dave?
I don't know. I think they used to buy the bag, right?
I'm going tomorrow to see if my liquor store still got another one, because I'd like one, at least one more. It's 55 in Valdosta. Ray, I've lived in Georgia. You can keep Georgia in Valdosta. Ooh. I lived in the armpit of Georgia. I lived in Macon for 3 years.
Who lives in Valdosta?
Ray Cone.
It's colder than that here.
I had a gold store there.
It's 49 out here.
I had a gold store right beside the Sonic off of exit 16. I think it's 16. It used to be an old movie gallery building. There we go.
All right. Man, 61 people have nothing else better than on a Friday night like us. This is terrible.
I know, right?
We need some new blood here. Somebody new come on and see us.
Yeah, why not? Gotta start somewhere.
I'm about to get Marcia a webcam so she can come tell all.
What happened to her?
Yeah, here's the bag.
Yeah, no, bags used to sell back in the day.
Yeah, there's some listed.
Do they still sell?
I mean, Crown bag. Is it called a bag or a sachet or?
Yeah, sack.
Harlan gives me an LOL. That's my goal tomorrow, Harlan, is to find a webcam tomorrow while I'm at the yard sales.
For what? Do I want to know?
To get the Marcia.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I thought you were talking about the Ram still.
I was like, okay. I don't know what we're talking about here.
And nobody wants to see Franklin rub his dog meat down the ramp.
No.
Boredom, you don't have to worry about it because Harlan and I are going to kick ass tomorrow. Tomorrow is just setting up just for us to just stomp the shit out of it. We're going to fill the van up tomorrow.
Jake's on it.
Boredom, you want to know how well we're going to do tomorrow? I'm going to get up 15 minutes early just to put the cargo carrier on top of the van because we're going to fill that up and the van up tomorrow. That's what we're going to do.
There you go.
You're taking it from nobody.
So Ray, I like that business model. I like being able to buy that many and stuff just sells weekly after week. Except for the big girls. The damn big girls have taunted me. They haven't bought anything this week.
They're taunting me.
I have sold no big girl stuff this week, by the way.
Now is Ray going to come to Nashville?
So I'm not shouting out any of the big girls tonight because no 3Xs or 2Xs have sold this week. And then I'm had the lasting memory of 2 weeks ago. Okay, so tell me if this big girl did me wrong. She sends me a message on eBay saying she thought the briefs were underwear, and I'm sitting here thinking, they're fucking briefs. Briefs are underwear, big girl. I really was expecting something else. I'm sending them back. They've not been opened. So I took the return. Well, I have all the returns anyway because they're free. And I gave her money back. And I trusted big girl. And I'm looking at them the other day. And one of them, she cut open to take it out, I guess, to look at it. I'm like, big girls. So somebody explain this to me, all you big girls. Every single one of these flexies has a Ziploc on it. You think that you big girls would know how to operate a fucking Ziploc when you're in the refrigerators? Why can you not open the underwear that way? Damn it!
The refrigerator.
Why do you need a knife? Why do you need a knife to cut open something that's got a zip? That's got this Ziploc on it. Damn it! So she lied when she said none of them have been used or opened, except the one that you cut open. Damn it! I'm thinking about Mr. Sadie. I'm thinking about doing the big girl whatnot.
Ooh,
the big girl what? I'm gonna have to figure out how something to call it something else. So I don't think I can call it the big girl whatnot without offending to me.
How many sizes you got left?
I've got 2X and 3X and flexies, and there's like 4 styles. So, okay.
That'd be funny. Next up,
2X. So tomorrow, Dave, you got an assignment tomorrow. You need to call Scott Condon and tell him it's your fault that I hadn't sent him any flexies yet.
Oh yeah, it's my fault. How's that?
Because you taught me to sell it on Walmart tonight.
Well, you know, makes more sense.
They probably wanted a taste of Ray. We're not talking about the disgusting. Nobody wants underwear cheese. Come on now. So Ray, what Nashville is the Nashville Flippers, Dustin and Ray are putting together a meetup on April 26th to 28th. And I've decided, so Phil and I were going to do a meetup. We did one a couple of years ago, and we're going to do one again this year. But when Nashville Flippers said, hey, we're doing one in Nashville, we're like, okay, we'll just go to that one instead. So we're taking over the Nashville Flippers meetup. So it's April 26th to 28th. All my friends are going to be there. So, and I've only got like 6 friends. So you might as well come see us.
Michigan, that's where those links are.
Michigan girl says I'm killing her. I'm glad I'm being entertaining, Michigan girl. I'm trying. This show has probably already been put on limited. I'd be shocked if this show is not
already restricted.
Yeah. It's not.
It just hasn't caught up with it yet.
It is not. She probably chewed into the bag. Son of a bitch. Ray, your mind is worse than mine, buddy. Terrible. In a great way, by the way. Yeah, it's just. And I got a return today from an item. The lady said she's allergic to it, so she's returning it. She bought a 2-pack. She opened both of them in the 2-pack, even though she says she was allergic to it. Can somebody explain that to me? Why, if you ordered a 2-pack, why would you open both of them and then return them saying you're allergic to them? Am I the only one that if I order 2 of something, I open the first one and I use the first one, and when I'm done with that one, I open the second one? Is that weird? How many people, when you order multiple items, just go ahead and go, you know what? I'm gonna open them.
Gotta check.
Depends.
It's crazy. I'm just gonna open them. You know, I've had a lot of crown tonight, so y'all have to help me with this one.
Just a little bit.
And Larry, they're allergic to it. This is awesome. And why do customers not read? Somebody explain to me. I got a bunch of resellers in the chat. Somebody explain this one to me. I sell discontinued items. So most of the items I sell are more expensive. So why do you determine that if you order an item and you pay like, let's say six times what retail is, why do you think you're getting six of that fucking item? It says you're getting one glass, but you're paying $50 for this $10 glass. Why do you think that? Because it says one glass, but you're paying $50. Why do you think you're getting five of them?
It's a fascinating thing when you're selling certain things that get to a certain point and it triggers that same fucking response out of like all kinds of different people.
I mean, last time I spent this money on this item, I got three of them. Well, last time you spent that and you got three of them, they used to make this shit.
They don't now.
Oh, Lord, have mercy. How many beers are we allowed to have on one show? Man, where are you? Are you in Hawaii?
Where are you?
I'm in Hawaii.
No way.
Can't see the water, but.
Hey, are you driving a blue car in case they try to kill people with that?
I don't know what you're talking about, so no.
So if everything catches on fire, you want to be in a blue car or blue building so that it doesn't catch on fire.
Okay.
Yeah, it's got to have a blue roof.
No, the rental car is definitely an adjustment. It's got so many beeps and bells and whistles, and can't I just drive?
What the hell did you rent?
It's a
Yugo?
Chrysler Pacifica.
Oh, my God. You'll be lucky to leave you on the side of the road.
Well, yeah, and then you go to back into a parking spot, and it tilts the mirrors. I'm like, I want to see what's behind me, not the ground. Sorry, I'm old school. So
my radar detector hates those cars, so it goes off on all Hondas and all Pacificas. I don't
That's hilarious.
Oh, it's probably the
Ray, did you tell that guy here's your sign, buddy? What the I wouldn't even answer that guy. Does it run?
Well,
if you're in a Flintstones video, it runs. Right.
Wow.
So is this your reseller profits or is this you driving a truck profits?
Oh, no. Jeff paid for this all the way. This is none of this came from my real job. No, this is all from Uncle Jeff.
Tracy, you can stay up all night, buddy, because you're not allowed to go to yard sales and markets. Harlan and I are going to buy everything.
Oh, yeah, you're out.
Everything. You stay up late, spend some time talking to your wife, sleeping in the morning, because Harlan and I are going to buy it all. So speaking of that, I meant to ask Harlan, if you're still listening, that last estate sale we went to and the room in the back that had the shoes, there was a lady that came in there and then all of a sudden that bitch crop dusted us because all of a sudden that room smelled like somebody died in that room. And I meant to ask you about that and I forgot. I'm like, I'm sitting here thinking I've got to go out to the bathroom this way because it's one of those, it was a back bedroom that had an entrance in here and you could go out to the bathroom. I'm like, I'm almost about to gag. We got crop dusted. That was terrible. So Ansley, Dave has a program that plays sounds. That was a, was that a boat? Was that a ship, Dave?
That was a battle horn.
A battle horn of some sort. Tracy, you already mapped that estate sale, man, and it didn't. When I went in that room, it didn't smell that way. And by the time I tried to get out of it, that lady, she needed to seek professional help. Yeah, I need to make mine wear a bird. I'm about to do it outside on the PC. I mean, absolutely awful, man. That lady, that she got me.
I would say, Mr. Sadie, that the homelessness, I've seen a few. I'm in Waikiki. And for me, it's less than usual because in Seattle and Portland, oh, my God, it's everywhere. You can't make a turn without having someone. Every freeway on ramp, we've got it the worst.
Hey, have you met
the whole West Coast?
Have you met Dog the Bounty Hunter yet?
No, I haven't. Which island's he on?
Hawaii. I don't know.
Yeah, that one. Someone told me that before I left.
All right, somebody in the chat, y'all smart. Y'all way smarter than we are. What Hawaiian island does Dog the Bounty Hunter operate on? I don't think he does much. Ever since his wife Beth passed away, I mean, you see him every now and then, but not like he did. You know, they were married a long time. Have we done our time yet? Is it time for me to go to bed? Wow. Tracy's going to bed. I need to get some sleep so that I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
It's almost 10 o'clock. All right, we have 7 minutes left. What do y'all want us to talk about for 7 minutes? Jacob is so bored with us, he's reading his phone.
Whoa.
I was looking up where Dog the Bounty Hunter was. But I can't, it doesn't tell me.
Yeah, you're the information guy. You're supposed to be on this. What the hell?
Michigan girl, did he really get remarried? Man, don't say that. After he professed his love for Beth for that much.
Francie Chapman have moved to Marco Island. Dog and his wife, yes. Francie.
It's gotta be one of the smaller ones then.
But it's in Florida. It's Florida. They're in Florida now. They moved to Florida in 2023.
Hey. In 2023, he revealed he has secretly fathered a 13th child. Oh. Damn. Folks, that's proof right there. If somebody ugly like Dog the Bounty Hunter can have 13 kids, you can get on Whatnot and sell your shit. I'm telling you right there. That's 100%, that's 100% the truth. Wikipedia only says 12 kids, but... No, he's. She died at 19, and he married again in 2021. Damn it, Dog! Can you not be by yourself alone for like 5 minutes? Shit. He's married once, divorced, married twice, divorced, married three times, married four times, married. This is wife number six. Damn, Dog!
Holy shit!
He's on wife number six. I try to trip a little. I'm gonna go on my own comedy tour.
Make sure Crown sponsors you.
I know, right?
Looks like it has tonight.
That's what I'm saying.
We need you, Crown. Come, please. Crown Royal, we love it.
Please sponsor.
Look how empty the bottle is.
Make sure it's empty.
I wrung mine out.
No. Oops. He's named Mike said he's named dog for a reason. You're right, Mike.
So I have a question. See if I won a contest I didn't want to win. What's the longest time for a merchant fulfilled return that you've had?
What's your return policy? Same as Amazon's?
Same as Amazon's, but you know how they can violate it. How long have you ever had one go?
So they tried to get, I've had one like 60 or 90 days. They tried, but they
60 seems to be the.
But once I filed a safety claim, they gave my money back.
Right.
Right. So I had one that was right before I left, I had something returned to me for 9 months.
Oh, well.
See, they shouldn't have done that. See, I've had a couple of them that I've had this crazy bitch trying to return a toy that her kid broke after like 122 days. Mm-hmm. And I told her I denied the return because it's outside the 30 days.
Right. So they opened the return within 20 days. Mm-hmm. But I received the product back 9 months after they purchased it.
No, they're required to return it within 30 days. Just open a safety claim.
Well,
so did they get their money back the moment that it hit the first scan? Is that no?
No, no. I was in control. So I did partially refund. Mm. And it was a high dollar item. So we'll see how it turns out. I only gave him back 50%.
That's probably your best bet.
But it was a $600 item. So this could go south. We'll see.
So Mark said he sanitized his own comment. Nice, Mark. We appreciate that. After all that crap, I don't have the ability to sanitize my own comments. So you never know what's going to come out of my mouth. It's just absolutely amazing.